Morning. It's March the 12th, and we're going to plant these Ailsa Craig onions that we planted back in January. We started them from seeds. We got the seeds from Baker Creek, and since then we've transplanted them twice. And you can see how nice and big these plants are getting, and they're actually getting root bound in these 32-ounce cups, so I got to get them in the ground. Last year, we planted them outside on March the 6th, but it was a little cold. So we're going to get them in this raised bed planter box we have here. It's just regular garden soil that we've had in the boxes for years. I did rebuild the box this year because it was falling apart, so we made a new box. And to the planting holes, we've got some blood meal that's high in nitrogen. And in that kitty litter bucket, we have rabbit manure that our friend gave us last year. And I stored it in the building, and now we're going to use it in the planting holes along with that blood meal to help get these things off to a good start. And I'll kind of show you what they look like here. You can see that if it's picking it up. It's early in the morning. I got some things to do, so we're going to get these planted as early as we can. But you can see how root bound these guys are getting. So we're going to go ahead and get these guys planted today. And we're supposed to get some colder weather coming in. It's supposed to be 70 today, but we're getting colder weather coming in by the weekend. But I'm going to go ahead and cover these too. I'm going to build a little frame around the top of this guy, and then I'll be able to put some plastic over it when we get the 30 degree nights. Trying to find my little scare of these. So this is a 2/3 cup scoop, so I just take a little scoop of rabbit manure. This is composted down real nice. And then I'll take a tablespoon of this blood meal. Hope it's picking it up. There we go, there's one done. can see. That's why we're getting a jump on it. Tablespoon of blood meal. These are really nice looking onion plants. Now, your onion plants like a lot of nitrogen to grow these big green tops. And every leaf on this onion plant is a ring. Every one of these leaves is a ring on your onion bulb. So the bigger we can get these tops early in the season with some nitrogen, the bigger the bulb will be later on. Lord willing, they make it. That's why we're adding the rabbit manure. It's high in nitrogen, and the blood meal is high in nitrogen, and they're both organic. Thank you. so it's time. This box is 7 foot long and 46 inches wide, almost 4 foot. And I've got 18 onion plants. We was able to space them about a foot apart. Now, these things would probably grow bigger had we had more spacing, but that leaves me one left over, and I can give that away to one of my friends. And we can fill this box in. And if they're a little smaller because they're crowded, well, that's okay too. Now, as I'm taking these things out of here, some of the green tops are breaking, but that's okay. They're going to keep growing. If I break a couple, that's all right. That's part of the game. Nothing perfect in gardening. And this manure that I'm using, this rabbit manure is one of the manures you can use immediately. You don't have to let it age or compost. I just got this stuff late last year, so it was past planting time for anything, so we just left it in the building in the bucket. But if you were using like a horse manure, steer manure, cow manure, chicken manure, you may want to let that stuff compost down for a year before you put it right on your plants so you don't have any damage done to your plants. But rabbit manure, you can use it fresh out of the bunny. So we'll go ahead and get these last four done, and we'll call it a wrap. Nice looking plant. See, thank you. All right. So there we go. They're all planted. Now the only thing left to do is water them in. I'm going to have to go open my rain barrels. We've had some rain and I'll have to dig out some my watering can.